know about the present situations of the Afghanistan and the previous history of the Afghanistan, because the Afghanistan is a very good language. Once upon a time it was a part of India, undivided India, and the British, they got freedom in 1919 from the British Empire, and subsequently the Afghanistan became the one of the land in where the so many forces tied their level base to do their base camp practically, because no country except India, no country they didn't apply their mind for the benevolent work for the ordinary Afghan peoples. Number one. Number two is that the Afghan peoples are very much good peoples, and they are the very peace-loving citizens of the Afghanistan. And because if you see the history of the Afghans, the Afghans are very good, ordinary Afghans peoples, they have maintained very good relations with India. Because in our great poet, Rabindranath Tagore, the famous writer in his own book, that is named the Kabliwala, that is because he has mentioned the categorically the lifestyle of the Afghan people and the love and affections for the young girl who is staying in the Calcutta, because they are practically doing work, and they from the Afghan they came to Calcutta, came to the different parts of India for their business, and also due to the love and affections of the one young girl. It was written by the Rabindranath Tagore in his different book. The Afghan always maintained India and Afghan the very good friendship relations. It was continued from a couple of years, and now the problem is that because the Afghan, when the Afghan faced the terrorism attack, especially by the Taliban, so-called terrorist organizations in the name of Islamic fundamentalists, those who are also they are earning the bad name of the Islam. Never says the such type of terrorism in the history of the Islam, but they are misusing the name of the Islam, the Taliban organizations, and they are also creating problem all over the Afghan peoples. If you go to the some decades before that, you can see that when the main problem started in the 1970. The Soviet Union, before the disaggregations of the Soviet territory, the Soviet sent the force in the Afghan to control the political situations in the Afghanistan. But they failed to do so. In 1989, the Soviet army, they returned back from the Afghanistan, and the Najibullah became the prime minister of the president of the Afghanistan, and he did lot for the Afghanistan, because I have very good respect upon the late Najibullah. He was a progressive person, and he wanted that to reforms of the Islamic culture in the Afghan, and also moderate Islamic culture he tried to start in the territory of the Afghan, which indicates the peace and the peace of the all over the Afghan peoples. Now the problem is that because Najibullah, when he became the president of the Afghanistan, he started to build up the friendship with the different countries of the Southeast Asia. And also he got the very good help from the India. And subsequently, in the decades of 1990, it was in 1996, he was in India, his family was in India, and very unfortunately when he returned back to Afghanistan, he was brutally butchered by the Talibans in the name of jihadi. So after the demise of the late Najibullah, the former president of the Afghanistan, so it was a very horrible situation for the Afghanist people, because the at that time the Talibans and the Pakistans, our neighbors' country, they tried to build up the entire terrorist organizations in the Southeast Asia, and they tried to build up a base camp for the terrorism activities. From the base camp, they tried to contact, they had to maintain the all type of terrorism wars all over this country, especially in India, also in America, also in Russia, also in China. And due to the, you know, the 2000, when the America faced the very big terrorist attack in their territory, then America decided to send their force in the Afghanistan, and also the last 20 years the American force was in the Afghanistan, and then they tried to build up the new Afghanistans, reformatic Afghanistans, with the help of the other countries in the Southeast Asia. India also extending their help to the Afghanistans for the benevolent of the ordinary people. India has helped the Afghan government to build up the hospital, build up the other necessary of the life, like hospital, gym, and also the food center and others development work. India did lot for the Afghanist peoples, and include also I have to say the entire modern Afghanistan constructions of the new construction of the Afghanistan, like a parliament house, like a secretariat building, all are constructed by the Indian government, because India government also tried to extend their help only for the ordinary Afghanistan peoples, those who are very peace loving. But unfortunately, the America withdrew their force from the Afghanistan, and the horrible situation started from the before some days ago. Now the problem is that due to the capturing of the power by the Talibans, because the Talibans, they didn't believe in the democracy. They are not bothered about the democratic pattern system of government, the humanitarian phase. Also, they believe in the independence of the woman and child. Because if you see the latest positions of the Afghans, so many Afghans reformatic leaders, including their ex-president, also the different type of the persons of the society, they have escaped from the Afghanistan only for their fate of life. And it's a horrible situation for the Afghan. Now, before 2 or 3 days ago, that we have seen the blast was committed by the terrorist group. So many ordinary child, the ordinary lady, they are also asking help from in the international level, that their life has been practically butchered, their life has been practically facing the horrible situations by the Taliban, because the Talibans are also practically practically they don't believe at all in the freedom of speech, freedom of women, freedom of child. So it's a practically horrible situations. In these situations, so the others developed country of this world, they can't be silent spectator. They should raise their voice, because now the America government, they have withdrawn the force. Now last day's incidents, that the blast was committed by some of the terrorist group, and that 15 American force, they passed away due to the blast, and ordinary 70 Afghan citizens, they face the death due to blast. In these situations, only the way to set up the democratic pattern of government and international community, especially the international international big power country like Russia, like America, like India, they should make a plan and also to establish, to set up the democratic pattern of government in the territory of Afghan to maintain the peace of the ordinary Afghan peoples. It is my personal view, which I have observed from the seeing the different news item also which was telecasted in the media. If you ask me my personal opinion, I can say that the Taliban's became the Frankenstein of America, because once upon a time the Taliban's got several indulgences from the American lobby, American intelligence branch. Now it became the Frankenstein's to the America. And also if you ask me to say something about the Pakistan's, and Pakistan is giving indulgences to the Afghan terrorist group of Afghanistan, but it is very dangerous, dangerous for the Pakistan's peoples also. A large number of the Pakistan, Afghanistan are there as refugees. They are going to take shelter in the neighbors' country like Pakistan, Uzbekistan and others, and the rest of this others' country. But the problem is that the Pakistan's now they are giving indulgences to Taliban's. But the Taliban's, because Taliban's, it will be the Frankenstein for the Pakistan's also. Because if you give the indulgences to the terrorisms, if you give indulgences to the such type of activities of the Taliban's, it will be 100%, it will be fair back also Frankenstein's for the same Pakistan, which they have already faced. Because in Pakistan, we know that there is no democratic system. Ordinary people are staying in the under poverty line. They have so many terrorist organizations is working in the field of Pakistan, and the terrorist organizations also, they are using the Pakistan's land as their terrorist activities. It will be very backfiring for the Pakistan's government. So therefore, because terrorism is terrorism. Terrorism has no any caste, terrorism has no any religious. Because if the Pakistan's and others country, if they think that the Taliban, they can use it for their own purpose, it will be never happen. The Taliban will be the Frankenstein for that the country of those who are giving the indulgences to Taliban. That is my personal view. And I appeal by your media to the United Nations to look into this matter of the, to protect the freedom and the of, and also the constitutional human rights of the ordinary child of the Afghanistan, ordinary peoples of the Afghanistan, ordinary women of the Afghanistan, because they are living in very crisis time, and their freedom of speech, their constitutional right, and their rights are also peril in dangers, and also they are facing the slaughter of democracy in the arena of their land. So the Afghan peoples, I pray to God and appeal to the all developed country, including our United Nations, to stand behind the ordinary peoples of Afghanistan, those who are fond of peace, and those who are the very innocent peoples of this land.
Thank you.